Last time then we were talking about garbage collection, and in that I was using a finalizer purely so we could output a message to see when garbage collection was happening, which is something that's quite interesting, but not what you do in normal programming. So this week I thought we'd look at the situations where we use finalize, and we'll actually discover that in real life it's pretty rare that you use it. Finalize is very closely connected with another much more commonly used method called dispose, and so we'll look at how the two of those interact. So what I've got here in this program is a class called Pure Managed Class, and that just has a member of this type, StreamWriter, for writing text out to a file. And we can see there we've got a method called StartWriting, so if we want to use it, that is what initializes it. And as you can imagine, one of the things you've got to do with StreamWriter, with anything that connects to a file, is you've got to close the file afterwards. And that's all handled for you by the fact that StreamWriter, which is derived from TextWriter, but TextWriter implements iDisposable, therefore has the dispose method, and that is what does the shutdown, the disconnection from the file. So if we were using StreamWriter directly, we'd put it in a using block, but because we're using it inside a class, our pure managed class, which is itself iDisposable, so on the dispose there, I just pop out a message, again, purely for debugging purposes, but then we call dispose on the writer using the question mark just to check that it's been created at all, because we didn't necessarily have to call start writing. And so now that simply means that whoever uses pure managed class has to make sure that they call dispose on that, and this should all be okay. So the way that would happen, here we've got the program, so I've got a main calling run, and then I do this garbage collect just so we'll force a garbage collection at that point. Not that it actually matters for dispose, but it's going to matter later on. And then what I'm going to do is say using, and then pure managed class, and let's just call that PMC equals new and all of that. And then let's say PMC dot start writing. So that will create the stream writer. And then we'll see when we run that, that it says disposing, because when it left the block in which it was declared as using, then when it went through that curly brace, it did the dispose. And so that's a pretty safe way to go. But the problem is, of course, that even in our class, if we do all the right things like we've done here, if the client code forgets to do the using block, then we don't get the dispose called, and so we don't get correct tidy up. And the really important thing about that is we're in complete control of when that happens. So by putting in the using, we know that it's going to be, as soon as we've finished with the class, it's going to be disposed. We're going to get rid of those resources that we don't need anymore, like the connection to the file. But if we forget, then we can see we've got problems. And that's why we have a finalizer, because what I can also do, if we've forgotten to do that, but I could put in the finalizer here, which has the syntax tilde, and then the name of the class. So this actually comes from C++ originally, but it's intended to be the opposite of the constructor, effectively. And then all I'm going to do in here for now is just put the message so we can see what's happening. So finalizing. And so now when we run that, we can see it says finalizing, and that happened when we went through here. It's worth noting a slight subtle difference between .NET Framework and .NET Core. In .NET Framework, when the program terminated, then any finalizers got called. Whereas in Core, although they get called when we explicitly ask for it or when a garbage collect happens, it doesn't happen on termination. So that's why I need that in there as that last line. So we can see that's working. But that then hits us with another problem, which is, well, what now if the user does remember to put this in a using block? And we'll see now that we get both the disposing and the finalizing. And that's something we really don't want to happen for two reasons. One is it could simply be inefficient doing the same thing twice. Once you've disposed, you don't need to finalize. But additionally, it could also break things, because if we try to close the file and then try to close it again, then that could give us an error. And so another thing we can do is inside a dispose, we can, having done whatever's necessary, we can say gc.suppressFinalize on ourselves. And so that means, although we've got a finalizer, it won't be called because we've suppressed it. And so now we can see, if we run that now, we just get the disposing, whereas if we miss off the using, we just get the finalizing. So that is the safe way to go. It's also worth mentioning, apart from the problem of doing it twice and that sort of thing, finalizing is inherently an inefficient thing to do. If you remember what was happening with the garbage collection when we looked at it last time, once all the objects that are not being collected have been marked and moved on to the next generation heap, then the remaining objects don't have to have anything explicit done to them. The heap pointer just drops down to the bottom of the heap and any new allocations just write over the existing objects. Well, you can't do that if you're finalizing, because those objects can't just be left there. They've also got to be finalized. So they're put into a thing called the finalizer queue, which then gets processed. Not horribly inefficient, but even if you had a completely empty finalizer, so simply by writing it in there, even if it had nothing at all, then that would slow things down. So that's why it's better if you don't need it not to have a finalizer. But it's also another reason why, if you do need a finalizer, then when you're not going to need it, get rid of it with suppressed finalizer. That said, though, in a class like this, the finalizer isn't really necessary at all. Notice I haven't duplicated that code and put the dispose in there. And indeed, if I do, we get this rather unpleasant error. And the reason for that is this. If we just consider this writer, this object of the class StreamWriter, in the finalizer, we're in the middle of the process of garbage collection. And so, as well as our object of pure managed class being garbage collected, the StreamWriter itself is also being garbage collected. And there is nothing we can do whatsoever to determine or manage the order in which that happens. Both of these objects will have been unmarked because they're unreachable, therefore the garbage collector deals with them, and it may already have disposed of the StreamWriter, and therefore we don't need to and we should not dispose of it for ourselves. So that's why I've highlighted the fact this is a pure managed class, because if you're entirely in the managed environment, if everything you've got is subject to garbage collection, then you never need finalizers at all. So we can simply remove that because it's just not something we're going to have. When then do we need to worry about finalization? Well, we need to worry about it if we are dealing with unmanaged classes. Now, this is something that in the early days of .NET you did lots and lots of, because there was lots of legacy code you had to access. But it becomes very less frequent these days, but it will still sometimes happen. And so what I've got here is a mixed class, and this, as well as having the StreamWriter, which is managed, therefore garbage collected, therefore we don't need to worry about, we've also got this com interop. So this is a way of connecting to Excel in this case, or any Office application, or indeed all sorts of other applications. So just to look at how I've done that, I've added a reference to this interop in there, and then I can make use of that in here. But the thing about it is unmanaged. Therefore, I've got to be much more careful about what's going on. So let's put that into the program. So let's have this mixed class, MC. Still got a method called start writing, so the same sort of thing that creates both of the objects. And so the thing we've got to do is, if we have a dispose, that's got to get rid of both the StreamWriter, which is managed, and the Excel object, which is unmanaged. But if we have a finalize, we only need to get rid of the Excel object, because the StreamWriter will already have been garbage collected. And that brings us on to the all singing, all dancing solution to this, which is the dispose pattern. Because if we go in here, and if I put onto mixed class the iDisposable interface, get hold of the namespace, and then when you go to the light bulb, you'll see that this actually gives us not just the ability to implement the interface, which would just write in the dispose method, but we've got this implement interface with the dispose pattern. And if I click on that, it puts in a huge amount of code that is really there to deal with any circumstances. So what it gives us is this implementation of dispose. So that's the actual dispose method from the iDisposable interface. But then it also gives us this overload of dispose, which is virtual and takes this Boolean called disposing. So what that Boolean means is if this is the dispose method being called at the end of a using block, then that will be true. Whereas if this is finalization during garbage collection, then that will be false. And so we can see in our actual dispose method, we call the other dispose, setting that to true, so saying this is disposal. And then, as we saw a little while earlier, we suppress the finalize. So that will be the normal dispose. But then we also, if we need to, and we do in this case, have the finalizer. And in that case, we call dispose, passing in that disposing flag as false. Now, you could do this in other ways, but it just makes life easier if we centralize both behaviors for finalization and dispose through this one method. We then have just this flag, dispose value, just to stop us doing it twice. So we check that that's not true. And then at the end of it all, we set it to true. Then we have if disposing. So this is the stuff we want to do only when it's a genuine dispose. And remember, that is tidying up the stream writer, the managed object. So here is where we say underscore writer question mark dot dispose. So what we had before, so basically in the simple case on the managed class, that's all we really needed to do. But then we can see that what we then do here is we tidy up the unmanaged code. So this is what wants to happen both when we're disposing and when we're finalizing. And so what I'll do here, the details don't matter too much. It's not really what this video is about, but I'm going to say if underscore Excel doesn't equal null, just in case it hasn't been created. And then I'm going to say Excel.quit. And then I'm going to say Marshall, get hold of the namespace for that. And then release com object on Excel. So that should do the tidy up for us. And you'll notice it's giving us a warning there. And what that warning is telling us is because this is .NET 5, which can run on multiple platforms, it doesn't like the fact that this actually is a Windows-only feature. So we can get around that by putting on this supported OS platform. And again, get another namespace for that. And just specify that this method will only work on Windows. And then for consistency, we need to put that on these other methods as well. So that's the full-blown version. So that means if it disposes, it will get rid of the writer and then also get rid of the com object. Whereas if it's finalizing, it will just get rid of the com object. And let's just put some code in there so we can see what's going on. So here we'll put disposing of writer. And then in here, we'll put releasing Excel. And then back in our program, if we remember to do this in the using block and we run it, then we'll see disposing of writer, releasing Excel. That happened in the dispose when we left the using block. Whereas if we miss it off, then it just says releasing Excel because we don't need to dispose the writer because that's already going to happen because it's a managed object as part of garbage collection. So that's the full-blown dispose pattern. And you can see it's only necessary if we're dealing with unmanaged objects in the case of our Excel interop there. If you're in a purely managed environment, completely forget about finalizers, forget therefore about the dispose pattern, and simply just use the dispose method as a direct implementation. That said, there is one thing to worry about, which is, well, hang on, if we write a class, it's okay for us to say when we write a class that it doesn't have any unmanaged content, but what if somebody derives from that class and therefore in the derived class starts having unmanaged content? And in fact, that's why, if you look at one minor detail of this, this dispose method is declared as virtual. So the idea is that even if we didn't have anything of our own to do, a derived class that had to worry about unmanaged code could still override this and that would work fine. And so that's why in a really purest way of doing things, it would be regarded here, for example, as this is not quite the right thing to do, because although our pure managed class doesn't need any complexity, doesn't need a finalizer, it could be derived from, and therefore we should have the dispose pattern just for that potential problem. And some code checkers will object to this. Obviously, if you know what's happening in your code, then it's not something to worry about. But if there is just this possibility, then actually the easiest thing to do is if we make that class sealed, then we know no one's going to derive from it, so no unmanaged code can be introduced. So that was just the final piece related to garbage collection, the use of finalizers, and it is extremely rare nowadays because use of non-managed classes is rare. But if you have got unmanaged classes, that's when you need to start thinking about adding a finalizer, and probably best done using some variant of that dispose pattern. But if not, don't go overboard, just have a simple dispose. That's how you deal with other managed objects. So I hope that was helpful. Next time, we're going to be looking at something completely different. But if you enjoyed that, do click the like button, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.